In this series of tutorials, we are learning Autodesk Inventor from start to finish. In the previous tutorial, we have learned sketch basics. Now, in this tutorial, we will solve some exercises based on what we learned in previous tutorial. To receive new video notification every alternate Monday, Wednesday and Saturday, please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. Please also like and share this video. Let's start with this tutorial. So in this tutorial, at first we will create this object. For that we will start one new part. So click here on new, then click here on metric and standard mm. Click on create. Then to start sketch, click here on start 2D sketch. Then we are not going to use these sketches for any 3D model, therefore you can select any plane. Suppose I will select this horizontal plane, click, then pan it, press middle mouse button and drag the mouse. Then we will start this sketch from this point. We will create this line of 100, 50, 80 and 50. Click here on line, then click here at this origin point. Take your cursor on this side, ensure that line is straight, then specify 100. Enter, then zoom minus and pan it on this side. Then take your cursor on this side, then 50, enter, then on this side, 80, enter, then take it below and once it track this point, just click there. Then zoom minus and pan it on this side. Then next is this 150, 100, and 150. Take your cursor on this side, then 150, enter, take it on this side, 100, enter, again on this side, ensure that it is straight, 150, enter. Then remaining shape we will create freehand. Just pan it below, take your cursor on this side, click. Then ensure that you are tracking it properly from bottom point and your line is straight. Click, take it below, click, then take it up to this point. Once it starts tracking that bottom point, click there, take it on this side, again track the point, click, then again click and close it back. Then right click, cancel. Then apply dimensions. So here it is also 50. So click here on general dimension, click on this line, take your cursor on this side, click, then to change dimension, click and make it 50, enter. Then length of this line will be this length of 250 minus this 100, that means this will be 150. So click, click, again click, 150, enter. Then this line is purple, that means it is not fully constrained. So what we will do, we will make it collinear with this line. So click here on collinear constraint, click on this line and this line. So here now it is fully constrained. Press escape. You can also check that, just take your cursor on this symbol, it is showing it is aligned with bottom line. Same way here. This coincident is showing it is aligned with bottom line. Then this circle of 60 diameter and it is at the midpoint of this vertical and horizontal line. Click here on center point circle. Take your cursor to this midpoint. Don't click there. Take it away so it will track it. Again take your cursor to this midpoint. Then take your cursor at the center. So here it is tracking both the midpoint. Click there. Take it away, then 60, enter. Same way, track this midpoint, take it below, click, take it away. So here radius is 40, that is diameter is 80 and location is also 80 and 115. So specify here 80, enter. Then to make it fully constrained, we will have to specify dimension. Click here on general dimension. Click here on this point, this line, click then this line, this point, click, then this point, this line, click, then make it 80, for that click 80, enter, then this line, this point, and click, and 115 is correct. Press escape. Then to relocate dimensions, you can take your cursor on the dimension. Once move symbol is shown, then press first mouse button and drag it. So here this first sketch is ready. Then save it, click here on save. Okay. And give any required name. Suppose I will make it one. Save. Then press middle mouse button twice. Then close. Then again new. Metric, standard mm, create. Again 2D sketch. Suppose this time I will select this vertical plane. Then pan it. Then next is this one. At first I will create this line of 75, then this line of 135 length and 45 degree angle. So click here on line. Click on this origin point, take your cursor on this side, 75, enter, zoom minus, then take your cursor on this side, specify length of 135, then press tab for angle, then you will have to specify this complete angle. Now from this horizontal line we want 45 degree, that means from this line that angle will be 180 minus 45, enter. So here it has specified that angle as 135. Press escape, zoom minus, and pan it on this side. Then arrange this dimension. Then to create this opposite sketch, we will have to mirror around this axis. And this axis will be parallel to this line. So we will create this center line. So click here on line. So before that we will activate this center line. Click on this end point. We want to create this line parallel to this line. So take your cursor to this line and take it away. So here it is showing parallel constraint. So take it away and click. Press escape. Then we will have to mirror it around this center line. For that click here on mirror. Then select this line, right click. Continue, then the center line, right click, OK. Zoom minus, pan. Then again, this portion can be created by creating mirror of this portion around this vertical line. So you can also type L for line. Click on this end point, take your cursor on this side, click, press escape. Then click on mirror. Then you can select multiple objects by taking your cursor in empty space, press and hold first mouse button and drag the mouse. Ensure that all the objects are inside it and release the mouse. Then right click, continue, then mirror line will be this center line, right click, OK. Same way we will have to mirror it around this line. So again type L for line, click, click. Right click, cancel. Then again mirror, select all these objects. Now I don't want to select this center line, so press Ctrl and click on this line. So it will be removed from selection. Then right click, continue. Ensure that you remove this line, otherwise your mirror will not be created. Then select this line, right click, OK. So here this mirror is created correctly. Then click here on hide all constraint and again click here on show all constraint. So here different constraints are applied. Now here it is not fully constrained. So what we will do, we will apply one constraint here. Suppose we will apply this equal constraint. Click on this line and this line. So here now it is fully constrained. And I will cancel this display of constraints. So just click here on hide all constraints. Then next is these circles of 80 and 60 radius, that is 120 diameter, 80 and 120 diameter. Center point circle, click center point here, take it away, then 80, enter, then again click on the center point, take it away, 120, enter, press escape. Then you can move these dimensions. So here this sketch is also ready. So just save it. Okay. Save. Then close it. Then new. 100 mm create. Then again start 2D sketch. Then I will select this plane. Then next is this sketch. So in this sketch, at first we will create this line of 225 length, then this line of 300 length, and angle between them is 150 degree. So click here on line, then specify first point here and second point here, then take it below, click, right click, cancel, then click on general dimension, click, click, again click, 225, enter, then click, 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 300, enter. Then again select this line, click, click, 150, enter. Then press middle mouse button twice. Then to convert these lines into center line, click here on center line, select this line. At first cancel this dimension. Press escape, select this line, control this line, and select this center line. Click outside. Then move it outside. So here these reference lines are ready. Then to create these circles of 45 and 90 diameter. Click here on center point circle, click on this end point, take it away, 45, enter. Again click on this end point, take it away, 90, enter. Then 180 and 120 diameter circle, click, 180, enter, click, 120, enter. Then 30 and 60 diameter, click on this end point, 30, enter, click, 60, enter. Then to create tangent lines, for that click here on line, click here, then once tangent symbol is shown, click, then I don't want these lines in center lines, so just cancel this center mode, then click, then again, once tangent symbol is shown, click, then same way here, click, then tangent symbol is shown, click, then click, and suppose we will click it here. Press escape, convert this into normal line, select this line, then right click and select this center line, press escape. Then to apply tangent constraints, so click here on tangent, select this circle and line, again this circle, this line, then this line and this circle, this line, this circle and this line. So here all the tangents has been applied. Then next is to trim unwanted portions. So click here on trim and remove these arcs. Press escape. So all the arcs has been removed. Then after trim it got under constraint. So for that we will specify some dimensions. So click here on general dimension. Click on this arc. Take it inside. Click. Then same way for this arc, click, take it inside, click. Then I don't want this portion in main object, I want it as a reference object. So press escape. Then to split these lines, click here on split and select this line and this line. Then press escape. Then select this line, press control, select this arc and this line. Then right click and click on construction. Then click here, zoom all, zoom, then zoom all. So here this object is also ready. So all the required sketches has been created. From the next tutorial, we will start learning 3D and we will also create some 3D models. Please like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching. We will again meet in next tutorial.